Hallo, hallo, Mic Test. You can see the percent profitability is around 64%. It is only by using one technical indicator, which is RSI. Hello, financial programmers. I'm Ritvik Dashora and I'm back with a new video and some new learnings. This is the first video of this playlist on TradingView PineScript strategies that I'll be making with you here. And if you are interested or passionate on making trading strategies, I'm here to help you out and you should be happy that you're at the right place. We all have heard about RSI technical indicator, right? But we all also know that RSI alone cannot be used to make profitable trades. The win rate of RSI strategy is always less than 40 or even 30%. So in this video, I am going to talk about tilted RSI strategy, where we will be analyzing the RSI numbers in a different way. We are not just focused on making trades on the basis of RSI numbers, whether it's 70 or 30, we will be focusing on the increase and decrease of RSI numbers as well. And on the basis of that, we'll see if we can make a good strategy. And guys, if you're new to my YouTube channel, on this channel, I upload videos related to trading strategies, making trading bots, implementation of highly valuable finance APIs, implementation of AI in finance, etc., etc. So if this is something that you are interested in, then just give me that one click, which is just subscribe to my YouTube channel and also hit on the bell icon. Because in this video, I will just talk about just one strategy. In the future, there are many more strategies coming. Okay, so let's see what are all the topics that we are going to cover before we write our code. We will talk about tilted RSI trading strategy and let's understand how it works. So basically, we'll be using RSI indicator PineScript code, which is already present in the TradingView platform. We'll just copy and paste it in our strategy. We'll have to make some changes, but yeah, we'll see. And as I mentioned in the beginning, rather than just RSI numbers, we will check increase and decrease in RSI numbers. So if RSI increases and price decreases, then it's a buy condition. If RSI decreases and price increases, it's a sell condition. There are a couple of more things that will be included in this buy and sell conditions that we'll see while writing the code. This is the PineScript Pine editor inside the TradingView platform. I think by now you guys already know what it is. So I'm starting with version 5, right? Then the strategy name is tilted RSI strategy, overlay true. I want to plot the graphs on this particular chart. The initial capital is say $1,000. So let's save this strategy as tilted RSI strategy YouTube video. Now let's do one thing. In the indicators tab, I'll just search for RSI, right? Over here, you'll see relative strength index. Let's just go here, right? Now just click on this two curly brackets. It says that it will give us the source code, right? So just click here. It's a protected code if you can see, but I am actually just interested in this code because I want to use this particular code in our strategy. So I have copied it. Let's come back to our RSI strategy, which is this one. Let's just paste everything here. So this is the RSI indicator that we have just copied from the source code. Now we'll have to delete these two lines because we are not making an indicator, we are making a strategy. So let's delete this. I'm also not interested in this because I am just interested in the RSI, right? So let's just delete this part. Let's keep RSI length, RSI source input, right? MA type input, it's not required because I'm not interested in Bollinger Bands, EMA, etc. I'm just interested in RSI. Let's just delete this as well. MA length is also not required. Bollinger Bands is also not required. Right, up and down are required. RSI is here. I am not interested in making a moving average of RSI. So again, I'll delete this part. Bollinger Band is not required. So what I'm doing here is I'm just deleting all the sections which are not required. I'm just interested to get the RSI code. So I think it's required till here, till we plot RSI. Right, we can delete all the things down below. Perfect. This is the starting. Now the RSI is basically this one. I'll be just sticking to this one and let's just make it full screen. Right, this is RSI graph. This is the normal candlesticks graph. So in this example, if we see, from for example, from this particular point to this point, the prices are actually going down, right? If I draw it like this, it's going down. But on the other hand, the same level of RSI is going up. So what it says is basically the uptrend or the reversal is about to come, right? If you follow this indicator. Secondly, the RSI values are also below 30 in this case. So again, this gives a good opportunity to buy. But actually, I'm more focused in this particular difference. There's a tilt in the RSI, a different tilt in RSI as compared to the tilt which is in the prices. So if whenever there is something like this happening, then in that case, I will take a position. So in this case, the prices are going down. The RSI is going up. The RSI was at, I would say, less than 30, although we'll define a particular number for this criteria. So in this graph, if you see the prices are going down, it's tilted downwards, but the tilt of RSI is in the different direction, which is upwards, then it says that we will take a buy position here, we'll go long, right? So in this area, we'll take a long position. And then you can see there was a very good bullish market after that for many candles, right? So this is the strategy, and this is exactly what we'll be doing for the short position as well. We will be looking for an increase in price but decrease in RSI. Then we will be taking a short position, that is an inversion in the price trend is coming, right? So let's come back to our strategy. Now in this case, if you see, I mentioned that we will see a downfall in price and an opposite movement in RSI. We'll have to understand that we'll have to define the number of candles we will look for a downward or an upward tilt, right? So in this case, just suppose that we will check 30 candles of RSI values and 30 candles of the prices. If they are in opposite direction, then we'll take the action, right? So let's see, bar candle is equal to, let's keep it as an input, and the default value is 30. The candles to go back, right? I'm also providing strength as another input, which is a float. The reason for this particular input is that there might be many incidences where the tilt is very small, right? In both the price level or the RSI level. Then in that case, we will have to provide the slope of that particular tilt. And by saying slope, I mean, we have to see how much decrease or increase in the prices have happened in that particular period, right? So let's suppose that we are looking for at least 1% of decrease in the prices. Then only if the RSI values go up, we will take a buy position. And same goes with the sell position as well. We will look for at least 1% increase in the prices, and if the RSI values go down, then we will take a sell position, right? So again, it's an input. You can play with this particular number. I am calling it as strength, right? So let's make the buy condition. Buy condition is equal to, there are two main things here. The first one is the RSI value, which was earlier, should be less than RSI, right? So if you want RSI's graph to be somewhat like this, an upward inclination, right? And another condition is the price should fall, right? And it should fall by at least 1%. Now, because I am looking for a fall, let's not consider close price, but let's take high, which was earlier, should be greater than high multiplied by 1 plus strength. Now, why 1 plus strength? As I mentioned earlier as well, I am looking for at least 1% of difference between the high values, right? Let's take one more condition here, which is normal RSI condition, right? Mostly the RSI condition is, it should be less than 30. Let's do 55 in this case, right? Again, we can change it if it's required. The sell condition is something similar. I'll just copy and paste it down, right? This should be greater than RSI. This should be less than this one. And this should be greater than, let's write some other number, let's say 45. Before writing the buy and sell entry conditions, I have a small information to you guys. Recently, I launched a course on Python for financial programming. This course is specifically made for everyone who want to learn Python from scratch. So, and I highly recommend you guys to at least check it. The link is fprithvik, which is financialprogrammingwithrithvik.com/python. And you'll see two options for Indian candidates, for non-Indian candidates. If we click on any one of them, this website will open up and you'll see the entire course duration down here. There are 5 sessions, 10 chapters, 22 videos, 10 quizzes, 3 assignments, 2 live projects. And these are the 2 live projects, and this is the entire syllabus. Again, This course is specifically made for everyone who are frustrated learning Python on their own. It's made for people who want to learn it from scratch and want to make a very, very strong foundation using the quizzes that I mentioned in the assignments that I have included in the course. There are two projects that I have covered in session 4 and session 5, which are stock analysis and investment portfolio creation on using some financial analysis. So yes, guys, if you're interested, please check it out and use RTK40 code to get an instant 40% discount. I'll tell you the link again, which is fpritvik.com/python. Let's come back to our code now. So if by condition, then I'll open a strategy.entry. Let's just write long and then comma strategy.long. Comment is again long, right? This is the first condition. If cell condition strategy.entry and then short, strategy.short and then comment short. Now let's provide a stop loss as well here. If strategy.position size, if it's greater than 0, then I'll create a exit order here, which is a stop loss order here, right? So what I've done here is long exit, right? From entry, which is long, this one, right? The stop loss is basically the price of that particular order. And then I've provided 8% stop loss, which is like 0.92, right? 1 minus 8% is equal to 0.92, right? And the second one, I'll just copy this one, paste it here. If the position size is less than 0, then this is a short exit. This one would be short. And then let's make the stop loss for short position to be 10%, right? Again, if you want, we can change it here anytime, right? That's it. So now what we'll have to do, let's just remove this RSI here and let's bring it down a bit here like this. And then let's first save it, Control S, and then add it to chart. If we add it to the chart, and I have done some basic changes in the input, I have provided RSI length to be 29, candles to go back 30, and trend strength to be 0.02. You can see the percent profitability is around 64%, which is not very good or not very bad. But again, it is only by using one technical indicator, which is RSI. If you just use RSI in the traditional way, it will be less than 30 or 40%, right? Even the profit factor is good. The number of trades are also decent, more than 100. The drawdown is a bit high, but it's fine. We can actually do some things to bring it a bit more down. I think we'll have to work on the stop loss section more, but it's okay. Again, as I mentioned, it's not the recommended strategy. It's just for education purpose. And yeah, the net profit is quite well. Right now, you can get this particular code that I have written in my Google Drive, and my already existing subscribers know that I share my Google Drive access with my Google Drive community members. And not only this code, there are many more codes saved in that particular Google Drive, including my trading bot. So before I tell you how to get an access of my Google Drive and you leave this video and go to my Google Drive, I would like to tell you that the next video will be about Bollinger Bands. People use Bollinger Bands in a very, very traditional way. I have made a drift Bollinger Band strategy, and this is the final result of this strategy. The profit, the percent profitability is more than 90%. The drawdown is very low. The profit factor is amazing. So yeah, if you don't want to miss out the strategy, then click on the subscribe button and also hit on the bell icon, because this video will be posted next week. Also, let me know in the comment section if you have any suggestions on any sort of strategy that I should cover in this particular YouTube channel. Now, how to get an access of my Google Drive? Just go to my YouTube channel and click on access to my Google Drive button. And over there, you'll see the entire steps on how to get my Google Drive access. It's very, very affordable. I would say less than a third of a coffee price. And there's a lot of material that is present over there. And I have actually hired an intern recently who is managing that particular Google Drive and will keep on engaging with you. For any freelancing work, reach out to me on this email address and I'll reply as soon as possible. Alright guys, thank you so much for watching this video till the end. You can click here to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Over there you'll see this entire playlist which is on making PineScript trading strategies, and over there is the most recent video that I've uploaded on YouTube channel. Down below you can see my website where you can explore my course and my communities. So yes, stay healthy and stay safe, and I'll see you in the next video next week. Until then, peace.